Now I would like to talk to you about the F of the A to I in fighting COVID-19. F stands for follow guidelines. There are a whole lot of guidelines that are coming up. There is already guidelines as to what you should be doing, what you should not be doing. There is guidelines for people who are coming from abroad and traveling. There are guidelines for quarantining ourselves, and all this will keep changing and a lot of new information will be adding. There are a whole lot of material already on TV again and again. There is a whole lot of social media spreading all this information, but let us to complete the whole scenario properly and not to miss out anything. Go through all these points once again. Stay home. We always say home sweet home. This is the best chance to experience this. For the first time in so many years, families have time to spend with each other. Keep up your moods and keep all around you pepped up. There is no safer place today than your home. This is the only place you have full control on, and you can make sure the virus does not enter your home following guidelines. Call ahead. If you have any symptoms or you think you have become a contact, you need to call for help and guidance. There are some ways to differentiate COVID-19 from common cold, flu, and allergies. All these conditions have similar symptoms. Allergies and common cold do not present with fever and cough commonly as in the case of COVID-19. Though regular viral infections like flu have similar symptoms, shortness of breath and difficulty to breathe is more seen in COVID-19. Sore throat and fatigue are more seen in flu and not in COVID-19. Running nose and sneezing are seen more in allergies and common cold. Greater suspicion of COVID-19 should be considered in people who have traveled abroad. The three main symptoms of COVID-19 are fever, sore throat, and difficulty in breathing. If you have any of these, you can search for the local authorities' contact information and get proper help and guidance. Separate yourself. It is necessary to separate yourself by a distance of at least 1 meter. This is because droplets from one's mouth can travel up to 1 meter while we talk, and we do not know if anybody around us carries the virus. Take care of waste. It is very necessary to make sure that all the waste is properly segregated and is put into plastic covers. You should be using double precaution, using two plastic covers, one over the other, and pack it properly, and then dispose the waste. Order in. If there is an option of not moving out to get whatever is required for you, and you can order it from home, that is the better choice. The less you get out of your home, the safer you are. These are the guidelines you have to follow when you are entering your home in order to fight COVID-19. Do not touch anything when you come home. First, you remove your shoes. It's good if you can remove it outside the house, or as soon as you come inside the house, you keep your separate place for it and then remove it and then come in. Disinfect your pet's paws if you took them for a walk. Remove your clothes and put them in a bag to be washed. Leave your keys, wallet, purse, bag in a box at the entry of your house. Have a shower if you can't wash all exposed areas. Wash your mobile phone, glasses with hot soapy spray or alcohol, which is a disinfectant. Clean with bleach all the surfaces of whatever you brought from outside before storing. And if you've been using gloves to do all this, carefully remove and dispose the gloves and then wash your hands. Complete disinfection is not possible. The goal is to minimize the risk. We have guidelines that you need to follow when leaving your home. You have to wear long sleeves, tie your hair, don't wear jewelry, makeup or cream. If you have a mask, put it on just before you leave. Try not to use public transport because there can be a lot of contamination in this. If you take a pet, try to avoid him or her brushing against surfaces. Take disposable tissues. Use them to cover your fingers when you touch surfaces. Crunch up your tissue, place it in a bag, close the bag and then dispose of it. If you cough or sneeze, do not do it in your hands or air. Do it with your elbow. Try not to use cash. But if you do, disinfect your hands. Wash your hands after touching any object or use hand sanitizer. Do not touch your face until you have clean hands. Practice social distancing, 1 to 2 meters from each other. Now, it's important to know who is called a contact of COVID-19. A contact is a person who is involved in any of the following activities from 2 days before and up to 14 days after the onset of symptoms in a patient. Supposing you were having face-to-face contact with a COVID-19 patient within 1 meter of distance for more than 15 minutes, then you are a contact. If you have been providing direct care for patients with COVID-19 without using proper personal protective equipment, then you are a contact. If you are staying in the same close environment as a COVID-19 patient, including sharing a workspace, classroom or household or being at the same gathering for any amount of time, then also you're a contact. Traveling in close proximity with a COVID-19 patient in any kind of conveyance. Persons who have been exposed to individuals with suspected COVID-19 are considered contacts and should be advised to monitor their health for 14 days from the last day of possible contact. Now, if a contact develops symptoms, then the following steps should be taken. Notify the receiving medical facility that a symptomatic contact will be arriving. While traveling to seek care, the contact should wear a medical mask. The contact should avoid taking public transport to the facility if possible. An ambulance can be called or the ill contact can be transported in a private vehicle with all windows open if possible. The symptomatic contact should be advised to perform respiratory hygiene and hand hygiene and to stand or sit as far away from others as possible, that is at least 1 meter, when in transit and when in the healthcare facility. Any surfaces that become soiled with respiratory secretions or other body fluids during transport should be cleaned with soap or detergent and then disinfected with a regular household product containing a 0.5% diluted bleach solution. This can kill almost every virus. There has been a lot of doubts and apprehension about usage of hydroxychloroquinolone, which has been found to have a good effect on cure of COVID-19. The National Task Force for COVID-19 right now recommends its use only for 2 groups of people. One is for those healthcare workers who are actually treating COVID-19 patients, and for households who have come in contact with people who have been tested for COVID-19 and those people have become positive. So others should refrain from taking this medicine because it has a lot of side effects, and already we are seeing patients who have taken these medicines being treated in ICUs as well as having had mortalities.